Abel, can we walk and talk?
Sure, man.
Abel, with the...
Estás esperando que nadie llame.
Even?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Hey. Where's my bag?
Your bag? You have a bag?
Yeah, right.
I think they took it. Yeah. Little black bag? Yeah.
Abel,
we can walk and talk.
Okay. Yeah. I'll see you Tuesday, Abel.
All right, see you.
I'll call you later.
You need a
on Tuesday, yeah.
Okay, see you up there.
Hey, sir. Good to see you.
How are you?
You doing okay? I got something for you. Hold on.
Hey, is that Hector?
Hey, yo, what's up?
I guess Canelo's waiting for me down.
Okay, take care, Abel. Good to see you.
Take this with you.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much.
Take care, Abel.
I'll talk to you.
Okay, Abel.
Abel, with you guys fighting Brooke, it seems like it kind of opens up the it opens it up for fighters to fight smaller fighters. I mean, there's rumors that Cotto's considering fighting Gamboa. I don't know if you've heard it. What do you take to that? Your Rocky's Gamboa.
Did you see Ben?
Yeah.
Can you please give him?
I sure will.
Please, thank you.
Okay. You know what? I hadn't heard of that.
Yeah.
But
what do you take to it? I mean, he's like, is this legit? I heard it yesterday. Well, I was like, wow.
Well, first of all, what weight does Gamboa fight at?
He fought last time, I think 135. Yeah.
No, he fights at 140. He fought Crawford at 140, didn't he?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Cotto fought at 140 also.
It was at 135, actually. He fought Crawford at 135.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cotto won his belt at 140, his first couple belts, right? So he was a mature man at 140. Then he's moved up to 47 and 54 and tried the 60. I think that fight is, if you look at their past, that fight is pretty, I mean, they fought at the same weight.
So you think it's a fair fight?
If they make that, I could see that. I wouldn't want to see Gamboa fight a Cotto without any kind of fights in between.
Yeah.
He hasn't fought in such a long time that he may not be sharp.
Yeah. Abel, hey, what would actually take to, what separates Brooke from Khan? Because, I mean, it's still a
lot separates. No, it's not. I'll tell you what. Khan got knocked out by Bradis Prescott at 135 pounds. At 135 pounds. He got knocked out by Danny Garcia at 140 pounds. And everybody that fought him after that hurt him or put him down.
Those are big punches. I mean, if they moved up, they could have easily carried that punch. I mean, Prescott carried
Prescott,
it to one...
Prescott fought at 135.
He carried it to 140, 147.
I'm not talking about Prescott. I'm talking about Khan.
Yeah.
Khan fought at 135. You're telling me that we're fighting two welterweights. I said, he's not a welterweight. He's a 35-pounder. Started at 35 pounds, then 40. Canelo said he fought him at 55. By the time he weighed in, by the time they got into the ring, he weighed 185.
Yeah.
Golovkin is only going to outweigh Brooke if he outweighs him by more than 10 pounds, no more than 10 pounds.
Yeah.
So, first of all, it's more even. The other thing is, Kell Brook fought at 147 his whole career. He's been a champion at 147. He's never been beaten. He's never been knocked out. So he's a guy that doesn't know how to lose. It's totally different. It's like apples and oranges.
Yeah.
I mean, if you compare their careers, had Kell Brook been knocked out like Khan, okay, then yes, I could see you... saying that it's the same type of fight, but it's not.
Yeah.
He's not the same kind of fighter.
Are we gonna eat?
We're gonna go.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Everyone, and I was saying, I was thinking about what you
Michael,
said.
Michael, we'll see you
later.
All
right, brother. All
right.
Yeah, good luck on the 10th.
You question Canelo's machismo when you're saying that if he doesn't fight Golovkin, his Mexican status.
I question the fact that he's talking, saying. If Canelo had said after the Cotto fight, here's the belt, I'm not a middleweight,
okay?
Then I think we all give him a pass because he's recognizing what he's not.
Yeah.
But for a Mexican to say, no, andamos con mamadas, you know, here we are, right here, we're going to fight. And then you just give up the belt without a fight? I mean, come on. What Mexican is not going to say, you know what, that guy's a coward?
Yeah.
But... whether it was he or whether his people that advised him just didn't advise him in a way that was the smartest thing for him to do for the situation. If he's not a middleweight, he's not a middleweight. We understand that. Here, take it. That's all I'm saying. It has nothing to do with the fact that he is a warrior, in my opinion. It just has to do with just talking things that he's not backing up.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback.